Hello, everyone. Happy E2. While we can't be together in person this year, I'm super excited to be able to connect with you digitally and have an incredible time. My name is Jess Boyce. I live in Tampa, Florida, in the United States, and I am one of the educator innovation leads on Team Flipgrid. I am a former classroom teacher. I taught math for 10 years before joining Flipgrid. And so this is a topic that is absolutely near and dear to my heart. So I am so excited to be able to share with you today, flipping out with Flipgrid in the STEM classroom. So different ways that you can incorporate Flipgrid into your classroom as it pertains to STEM or to STEAM. So what we're going to cover, we'll go through a very quick overview of what Flipgrid is, and we'll talk about different ways, as I mentioned, that you can incorporate it into your STEM classroom. I'll show you some incredible examples from educators all over the world that we've seen on Twitter. And you'll be able to, by the end of this session, you'll be able to create a topic and share it with your learning community. You'll be able to find relevant topics in the Discovery Library, and you'll be able to take some examples that I've shared with you and use them in your classroom right now. So with that, let's go ahead and dive right in and get started. So I always love to start by sharing Flipgrid's mission. And our mission is to help you empower every learner on the planet to share their voice and then respect the diverse voices of others. We truly believe that together we can build global empathy. So if you are not familiar with Flipgrid, we are a video discussion platform. And so basically what happens is it's completely asynchronous. Educators are able to share with their learners and the learners reply back via video, and they can have these beautiful conversations with one another. So the very first step in that is to create your topic. Your topic is going to be a discussion prompt. This can be a question, an idea, an experiment, anything that it is that you want your learning community to have a conversation about. So once you create your topic, you need to set access and then share it with the community. So you'll have a couple of different ways in which you can set access, and you'll see in that top picture there, you have the very first one is if you are a Google or Microsoft school, you can use your email domain. So this means anything that is after the at symbol, you simply add that in, and then your students can authenticate into the topic using their regular O365 or G Suite credentials. Please do note, though, sometimes students have a different email domain than educators, so you'll actually have to add in both of them so that you both can access the topic. So you have that option. Now, if you are not a Google or Microsoft school, or if you have younger learners or those who don't have access to email, another option would be to use the student username. So what happens here is you're able to put in the username, their first name, last name, and then create a username for them. This can be as little as 2 characters, so it can be their initials or their classroom ID number, or it can be larger than that if you want to put in their lunch pin or something that's easy for them to remember, and then they can use this to authenticate into the topic and share. The third option is an integration with Google Classroom. So if you use Google Classroom, all you need to do is sign in with that account right here, and it will actually import your class roster, and they'll be able to get into the topic straight from there. And once you've set your access, you simply share it with your community. You'll get your join code for each topic, and you'll be able to share it out with them. There's a lot of different ways that you'll notice in that picture there of how you can share it out, but you also can simply copy and paste the join code and share it with your students wherever it is that you communicate with them digitally. And then once you do that, the best part happens, the magic. You get to foster this social learning. You get to see your students come alive and share their beautiful and unique voices. So they can use Flipgrid.com on their web browser, or there's a free Flipgrid app on iOS or Android. It's available on Chromebooks. Anywhere that your students are learning, they're able to access Flipgrid completely for free. And then they can share their voices and have these gorgeous conversations with one another. So the question is, how can I use Flipgrid in my classroom, in STEM, in STEAM? So I'm going to show you a couple of ways. The first one is with collaboration. Working with peers is such an essential part of STEAM, and Flipgrid provides a space for students to collaborate with one another while working through problems, sharing discoveries, and reflecting on the learning process. When we think of feedback, a crucial part of inquiry is making corrections to learning. So you can use Flipgrid's reply feature to allow students to reply to one another as they work through the engineering loop and creating and retesting different results that they may get. You'll see here in this example, Avery actually uses the shorts feature in Flipgrid to do experiments with her students. She does these videos and then can send them to her learners and they can watch from there. Design thinking. The design process includes planning, prototyping, hypothesizing, testing, and reevaluating problems to find innovative solutions. Empathy and experimentation are critical parts of the design process, and Flipgrid is a perfect space to reflect on these steps along the way. You'll see here from these examples that students were able to talk through their design process, talk about mistakes that they've made, things that they've learned. They can go back and change different things and talk through it again. So even if you use Flipgrid to have a journal as you're trying different things and talking through that, it's really a great place to be able to go back and reflect, look while I'm going through the designing loop, the engineer loop, whatever process you want to call it, and see what steps changed, what was beneficial, and what was not. Now, in this time, a lot of people are still at home. There's a lot of remote learning going on. So Flipgrid is a brilliant way in order to have at-home investigations. So when we think investigations, we think of students really digging into new concepts, new skills, and reflecting on their learning and understanding and being able to share on Flipgrid. But it really is elevated right now while a lot of us are at home. So you can see these different examples here of students who are experimenting, investigating, digging in, and doing fun things at home and sharing out with their peers, but then also with their educator and getting to explore that way. I love this tweet from Melissa who says, "When COVID keeps you apart, technology like Flipgrid can bring you together. The girls in STEAM digitally collaborated by sharing their personalized Spiro rovers. Girls also practice digital citizenship with positive comments." How incredible is that? One of my favorite people to follow on Twitter is someone named Melissa Hayes in Ohio, and she has STEM challenges every single week with her students. Now, a couple of years ago, I had the great pleasure of being able to be in her classroom and watching these challenges go on. The week that I was there, they were building towers to hold pumpkins and different things like that, and really working with one another, going through their process and reevaluating different things. You can see all of these examples. I love seeing that she tweets it out every week of different things that they have built, that they have worked together with to come up with, and really challenging their thinking. Now I know that her students are at home right now as well, so it's really great to see that she's still posting those challenges. They're optional, but the students are getting super excited and involved, whether it be a cloud viewer, making a New Year's hat, or a party horn, or a Rube Goldberg machine to show different chain reactions. There's so much that can really get your students involved and excited to be participating in STEM, even if they're at home. But what's great is when she was in the classroom still as well, the students were working together and then would still use Flipgrid to reflect. As I mentioned earlier, while they're going through that process, Flipgrid can be a really valuable tool in that way. So where can you find resources in order to integrate Flipgrid into your STEM classroom? We have this beautiful area in Flipgrid called the Discovery Library. So when you log in, you'll be on your educator dashboard, and at the top of the screen, you will see a place where you can click on Discovery. Once you go into the Discovery Library, there are tens of thousands of topics that are ready to go. They have been created by educators. Some of you watching this, I'm sure, have created topics that are in the Discovery Library. So they've been created by educators all over the world. We have about 35,000 topics currently that are there, that are ready to go and are ready to be used. So what you can do is actually you can filter out. So you'll notice there that I just clicked on STEM and STEAM, and there was 900 topics already under that category in order for us to use. You can also filter by audience. So thinking about your grade level and grabbing the different topics that you need. And what happens is once you find the topic that you like, you can even search by keyword. So if you have something very specific that you're looking for, maybe you're working on coding or something like that, you can actually type that in. Once you find the topic that you like, you can read through it. You'll see it from the student perspective of everything that they will see, different links that are attached, the media, all of those things. And then you'll also see integration notes from the educator that shared this. So different thoughts and ideas that they may have in order for you to implement it in your classroom. And all you need to do is simply hit add topic, and you can then choose what group you have, and your group is your learning community. So your classroom, different things like that. You can add the topic right into the group that you already have created. And then what's beautiful is you can edit it to fit your needs. So if maybe you love this one topic, but you want the time limit to be different, you can go ahead and change the time limit. Or if you wanted to add a specific article or anything like that, the beauty in Flipgrid is that you as the educator are in complete control. So you can go in, you can make the necessary changes, and then you can share it out with your community. So the Discovery Library is a place that I would highly, highly recommend spending some time in getting to know those topics. Now, also in the Discovery Library, we have partners. So I mentioned that there are 35,000 topics that educators have created. Now, we also have partners that have created topics for you as well. So you'll notice just a few right here that I pulled that are specific to STEM and STEAM. So you'll see code.org, Discovery Education, Let's Talk Science, Minecraft, Day of Data, Turning Green, the Joshua Tree National State Park, all these different partners who have put together information and topics specifically for your classroom. So what happens is when you go into the Discovery Library, you will see a section for partners, and you can scroll through those and go to their partner page. You'll see trending topics that they have and all of the different topics that they've created, and you can filter those, you can search through them as well. And then it is the exact same process that I shared with you a little while ago. When you find ones that are good for you that you want to use in your classroom, you simply hit that add topic button and it comes over into your group and becomes your own. It is completely editable. Any changes that you want to make, you can absolutely do that. So I would highly recommend checking out these incredible Discovery Library partners. Something else to note about them as well is that it is completely free. So anything that they have created that it lives within Flipgrid is free for you to use, even if they are a product that you have to pay for regularly. The information inside of Flipgrid will be completely free. So it's a great place to go and get ideas and grab topics that are ready to use, ready to launch with your students. Another great place that you can go is our integration docs. So you will see here, I just took a screenshot so that you could kind of get a good grasp of it. If you go to help.flipgrid.com, or even if you're just at flipgrid.com, up at the top, you'll see a link to our Help Center. And we have a bunch of different categories there. Now, before I dig into this, I just want to talk to the Help Center for a second anyway. It is a wonderful resource for you to go. So even if you're looking for ideas or you have a question about Flipgrid that's not STEM related, but you just have a question in general, whether it be about specific things, how you give feedback or how you collaborate or how you allow your students to reply, anything that you could possibly need, you can search for. You'll see there's these different topics here, but there's also trending topics and there is a search feature. And there are hundreds of articles that have been written by our team. And as questions come in, we make sure that we create new articles. So a lot of times, if there's any questions that you have, you'll be able to find it within the Help Center. So I definitely would recommend going there anytime that you might have a question and searching for what it is that you're looking for. But back to the integration tab, you'll notice here that in under the section called Ideas, Tips, and Best Practices, there's a whole list of educator innovation or different ideas of things that you can use, ways that you can use Flipgrid in your classroom. But we have lots of integration docs, and they were written by either myself or one of the educator innovation leads, and we go through different ways that Flipgrid can be implemented in the classroom. They are age and subject specific, so you can go in and find any different ones that you need. Maybe you teach year 7 maths like I taught. You can go and find those, or you want to look for Flipgrid in the arts or Flipgrid as a librarian or for professional development. They are all there for you, and they are under that Ideas, Tips, and Best Practices section in the Help Center. So this one, when we go into that section, there is one called Coding, Computer Science, and STEAM, written by my dear friend and colleague, Ann Cosma. So once you click into there, you'll see all the way on the right-hand side, I took just a little snapshot of it so that you could see an example, but there's much, much more to it than that. So I would highly suggest going there and looking for different ideas. Not only does it mention ways that you can implement Flipgrid in your classroom, but it also talks about different standards that you can hit, the ISTE standards that are part of that, and also it recommends really great people that you can follow on Twitter that are constantly sharing incredible ideas, like some of the ones that I shared with you earlier. Now, another way for you to get inspiration is to connect with us. We are all over social media. You'll see there, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook, just searching at Flipgrid. But I would also highly, highly recommend you searching the hashtag FlipgridForAll. This is a place that I personally get inspired daily by going through all of the tweets and seeing the incredible ways that educators are using Flipgrid in their classroom. But you can always filter to search for Flipgrid for All and STEAM, and you'll see incredible ideas. Flipgrid for All and STEM and science and technology, whatever it is specific that you're looking for, go ahead and scroll through and that hashtag, and you will find so many great ideas, I guarantee it. And we're here to support you, to amplify, to cheer, to share, connect with you. And a lot of you already know this. We've connected on social media before, but this is part of the engagement team and our Twitter handles. So don't ever hesitate to reach out to us. If you want to just be sharing different things that you're doing, tell us about the incredible ideas that you have for your STEM classroom. I want to hear about them. I want to share and celebrate with you. If you have questions, don't hesitate to reach out either. We are here to support that. That's what we love to do. Now, what you can do is earn recognition on the MEC for today's course. So all you need to do is log into education.microsoft.com. You'll see the second step here. You'll click on your profile circle in the upper right-hand corner and select Redeem Achievement Code. And then this is the code that you will enter for this specific session. I'll leave this up here for a second so that you can see there what it is. And when that box comes up, you'll type that code in, and then you will simply hit redeem, and that will allow you to get credit for or recognition for this specific session. So you can actually find the transcript for your session as well. So if you click to my profile, so again, you'll click on that picture of yourself in the upper right-hand corner. If you haven't updated it and it's still a little smiley face, go ahead and put a picture of yourself. So you'll click on that in the upper right-hand corner, and then you will click on my profile. And if you want, then you can go ahead and click my transcripts. And then if you aren't, so you can read right here, if you aren't an MIE yet, a Microsoft Innovative Educator, once you've joined for 2 hours of content, you'll be able to get that Microsoft Innovative Educator badge. The badging is something that we all really love, and there's so many incredible courses on the Microsoft Educator Center that you can take in order to get those badges. And that is all I have for you. Thank you so, so much for joining me, for flipping out with Flipgrid in the STEM classroom. Like I said earlier, if you have any questions, thoughts, ideas, please reach out and share them with us because we absolutely love to hear it. I hope that you have a fantastic rest of E2, and I look forward to seeing you on the grid.